With some bands, one can only hope that they achieve their well-deserved breakthrough, while simultaneously hoping that they don't, because perhaps as a result they would lose an element of their independence. Little Dragon is exactly one of those bands. The four musicians from Gothenburg in Sweden have known one another since their school days. With the albums they've released to date, titled Little Dragon and Machine Dreams, they've managed to show the extent of their musical spectrum. What plays a big role for them are the magical moments while actually making music. Maybe that's why the margins of pop have rarely sounded better.
Since we are three boys who are, we all have our little setup where we can produce, it's like one of us, we do work with Yukimi, and while the others are working on ideas, and then they will work on ideas with her, and me, for example, will continue. So it's like three little duos mixed in the same band. So then I think it's been really good, because it gives us a rich sound, sort of. We kind of have different inputs on the music, so.
Experimenting with sounds and stuff is something that's always been really important for us, and the guys are real sound nerds, so, you know, they love synthesizers and just, you know, playing around with different sounds and stuff. But I think it's part of our identity, kind of, to make pop songs, but not in the sort of commercial typical way, just sort of twist it all up and make it in your own way. But still, you know, we're very influenced by pop music and sort of classic songwriting.
Try to come up with something that sounds new. Try to stretch the music, what's already have been done, to stretch to do something slightly different, to so that the music develops.
I think all of us kind of like a raw sound, like when it's not too polished or not too produced, like it's a spontaneous creation of sound, and you don't have that time to just polish it and show it.
Motivation to make music is, I don't know, it's probably based on some very strong moment in life at a young age, you know, when music hits you the first time. And because it's so magic, you know, music is so powerful, and you want to get back to that first very magic feel. So it's both like a painful search for that moment, plus a lot of, you know, joy and happiness, because it's fun.
I think the Little Dragon dogma is probably to always try to, it's a bit cheesy, but always try to have fun when we make music, and not think too much about like goals and stuff, just sort of trying to be in the moment and you know, because once you release an album, you sort of, it's easy to get really high expectations of yourself and Everyone asks you about your plans and stuff, but you usually, I think we tend to make better music when we just sort of let everything stay really spontaneous, just like we've always done, just like, you know, a bunch of friends who are just trying to have a good time.
Way of looking on the music, that there's not a certain way of doing something. There's no like a formula, but there's so many other aspects of being creative, like this serendipity factor. Like you just make up something out of chance and mistake, and that tend to be like the most original idea you have for a week or something. I mean, or a year. I think not get too tied up in a program or something. Just try to see what happens. It's kind of a playful mentality that there's no school of way of doing things. It's just like we know what we like and we know what we don't like, so we see what we can do with the things we have.
I think our individuality is something that's grown with time. I think when we started, we were just, you know, we were in this studio making music, and I mean, our friends released like a little single, and you know, we couldn't even imagine what it would feel like to like see our music, you know, in a CD or in like on vinyl and stuff like that. We were super excited. So, I think. Just the journey of, you know, releasing music and everything has, you know, made you encounter all these situations where you've sort of had to deal with what our individuality means and what it is for us. So it's something that's grown, and we've had to kind of grow together that way, because being a band, you have all these different personalities and wills that have to, you know.
People, where have you been? Have you been hiding? Your big houses, people. After the rain, will your life, will it ever be the same? Oh, people, what will you do when your luck, when it turns on you? Oh, people.
I think the visuals are really important for us. It's just such a, I mean, I love art and I love finding other people that are creative, that are doing great things. And it's just, you know, there's so many ways to collaborate. So even in Gothenburg, it's a small city, but you know, like our press photos were our friends who live in the city, who are kind of graphic designers slash, you know, artists and photographers. And even on just like through MySpace, I've met so many great artists. It's really fun. So it's, you know, once you find something you love, you can actually integrate it with your music and, you know, have someone do the album cover, and it just adds so much to the impression. So, I mean, I think why not, you know, use that to, as much as you can, basically.
Rather be a band than a lover. Rather be a man with the other. To run the mountain down, run it down. Rather be a whisper in heaven than a daughter locked in your prison. So run the mountain down, run it down.
We try to practice when we're home. We're not that. Maybe usually our practice starts on tour, but we tried it. We sort of have to try out the songs because, it's not after we've finished a song, then it's sort of sampling all the sounds. We want to be able to play all the sounds live, not have to be, you know, have backtracks and feel limited. So, it usually takes a while. You're like, oh, the song's finished, let's rehearse. And then it's like, oh, no, we have to... So, yeah, it's a bit of a process. So once that is done and we have all the sounds ready to be able to be played, then we try to rehearse through it. And then, you know, with time it grows through playing it live. Jamming is a kind of important part of our... So even when we record, it's very spontaneous, like the jamming element to it. And even live, it's sort of, everything's played live, then things can happen, and, you know, songs change. I think live is really important. It's important because we can really feel how much we grow and change through playing live. And it's also important just because it's something that we really love. It's like one of those, you can have these amazing euphoric moments, you know, once you have amazing crowds and, you know, great sound and everything's just, you know, it's obviously not something that happens every show, but once you have that, you just feel so grateful.
For us, it's more for real when you play live. You can really try if a song is if it's good or not. If you just record something, it's more abstract. Yeah.
Broken up a blur, I can't recall. How many times have I been here before? Or could this be my birthdown?
We have some unwritten rules, perhaps. That is, they're not really official. But one is, for example, that we don't want to be stuck with backtracks when we play live. We want to decide the tempo when it's, at the moment. So there's no click-clack. Oh, we're too fast, you know, we're too slow today. So try to get that kind of live feel. I think we all are big fans of, the big stars who the ones who can really play live, who are not really, you know, there's so much playback going on. So we thought we should try to do it as real as possible.
Up and down the hill. Just when you think it's the end, then it's black, hiding in the dark, then a sudden flash of light, and then you're back.
I think our music is very based around what Yukimi is doing, so I think her voice I've been doing a lot of instrumental music as well, but now it feels like a voice is so important, because the voice is really reaching out to people. It's like, it's that bubble that's around the music, she's really destroying it and reaching out to people, and you know, they can feel it in a much more stronger emotional way.
Twice I turn my back on you,
some of the next steps are to develop as a group and a band and not get too stuck in a sound or roles. And we've been talking about the guys singing more and just develop the sound and not get used to develop as a band and people. And as people, and maybe work on the live show as well. Not get too not too bombastic and not too produced, but just to see if there are any other levels of doing a show.